brothers and sisters in Christ here in the Philippines and in abroad. Once again, I'm Joy Santiago. I will be your host for today's service. I hope wala kamong sumudan sa ako na wong. Nakapangapi na ang tanan? Nakapangahaw na?
Yes.
Okay, yes daw. So I'd like to give you all a warm welcome to our online home fellowship via Zoom as we give glory and praise to our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. So God is honored when we play our part. He gave us outstanding talents, skills, and wisdom that we must be grateful for. And we should claim it in His name. He deserves our key with Him, and we have been loved before we know it. And also, He knows better than we know ourselves. He knows many strands of hair there are in our heads, and as He knows what's in our hearts and our thoughts. Can we give a virtual clap to the Lord? Virtual clap, 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 clap. So before we officially start, let me call on Sis Jeline Letran for the opening prayer.
Lord God, thank you for today. Everything you do reveals your glory and majesty. Your acts are amazing, Lord. We cannot comprehend the number of blessings you pour out on us from day to day. As we gather here today in our virtual worship, we pray that you would fill our hearts, our minds, and our souls. Transform us, Lord, and make us more like you. Guide our thoughts and hearts in our worship today. Open our ears so that we may hear your voice. Open our minds so that we may receive your eternal wisdom. Send us your Holy Spirit to be our guide and give us the wisdom to understand and embrace the topic that we are going to discuss today. Open our spirits so that we may know your leading and guidance, and open our hearts so that we may receive your wonderful love. Let our hearts be filled with your praise. Let us never forget the good things you do for us. You have forgiven our sins. You have rescued us from death. You have crowned us with love and tender mercies. Lord God, with your Holy Spirit, anoint Attorney Dennis to preach your word, and as he preaches the word, let signs and wonders follow, confirming it. Renew our strength and refresh our souls. We ask all this in glorious name of Jesus. Amen.
Hello, everyone. Good to see your beautiful and handsome faces. So for the past 7 days, we have been indeed very busy with our duties and responsibilities, right? But definitely we're led by the Holy Spirit to present ourselves here online to fellowship with one another. And that is superb in His eyes. Let us allow God to reign over every part of our body. By being what? By being joyful at this very moment, because we are called what? To glorify Him. So sing, sing, sing with cheerfulness as we please as our dearest Lord Father. Together let us worship the name above all names, Jesus Christ.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning I shall rise to
Holy, 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 merciful and mighty Lord Jesus Christ, we love you so much. Good morning then sa'yo. So, good morning to Lord Gina. So, moving on, as we sing further again to God's Word, may we call on Attorney Cortes.
Okay, good morning to one and all. It's really a blessed Sunday. It is always a good thing for brethren to gather together. And in these times of pandemic, even though we cannot do that in person, at least thanks to the blessing of technology, we can gather online through this Zoom Ikthus East home worship service. And we are here, of course, to worship the Lord, to have fellowship one with one another, and most especially to worship the Lord by means of meditating on His living word. Okay, so for the past weeks, we have been studying about the second coming, and Pastor Daniel has also been, sharing messages which are connected to that topic. Okay, ang message niya last time was, I think, also about the last days. And today, we will actually be continuing our series. I did not expect actually this will really become a series. If you remember, we started with the comfort of the second coming. There are the First Thessalonians chapter 4. Then we just went along. We studied about how not to prepare for the second coming, then how to prepare for the second coming. And then a few Sundays ago, I remember preaching on being protected for the second coming by means of putting on the armor of God, the breastplate of faith and love, and the helmet of the hope of salvation. So, ari na kita actually, that was 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 8. And now we are in verse 9. Kag-continuation ni siya sa atong gintunan about being protected for the second coming. But this time, it will, the message is entitled, Secured for the Second Coming. Kag ininga aga, 1 Thessalonians 5 verses 9 to 11, I will show it on the screen in a little while. Okay, so subong aga, ang ato niya tunan is secured for the second coming. And this is part one. I was not expecting really to divide this message into two parts, no? So sub-series ni siya. But I realized while I was meditating on God's word, tama ni kalawig kung isahon ko lang ni kawali. So I had to divide the message into two parts. So we will only be studying part one, secured for the second coming, part one. And part two, siguro pearl ang matabo sini, padayunon ko ni next Sunday, no? Para there will not be a gap and we can, appreciate the continuity between the two messages. So, okay, let me put it on the screen. Our text for this morning, and if you have Bibles with you, please, open them, okay, to First Thessalonians, secured for the second coming. 1 Thessalonians 5, 9 to 11. Let's read that passage, and I'll go back all the way to... I-minimize ko na, dali lang get my log, I may get to do this ako. Okay. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, having put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us so that whether we are awake or asleep, we might live with Him. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. Lord, we commit this message to you. We are so thankful, O Lord, for your amazing grace. And my prayer today, O Lord, is that as we study your word, our hearts and minds will be opened, O Lord, to the vastness of your grace, that it is far greater, far deeper, more profound than we will ever realize. And as we study your word, I pray that your Holy Spirit will speak to our hearts, that your Holy Spirit will be the one to motivate and inspire our hearts to rejoice in your grace. And we pray that we will be drawn to worship you even more, to love you even more, to obey you even more, because, O Lord, the grace which you have given, which secures us, is truly amazing. It is more than we can ever imagine. It is higher than our thoughts, higher than the anything that we can conceive. We pray, O Lord, that as we continue to worship you, you will be truly glorified. You are everything, O Lord, and you are worthy of all our praise, all the glory, in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Okay, so, okay, let me just say this, no? Let's focus on the passage, no? So verse 8 to last time, the focus was on protecting ourselves from the wrath of God, if you remember, during the second coming. Kaya pag abot ni Jesus Christ, it will be a day of great blessing, okay? For those who are prepared, for those who are God's children. But for those who are not, of course, it will be a time of wrath. And of course, we want to make sure, no, that we are really God's people, we are really protected. So, dira nagsulod tong faith, hope, and love. Hindi ko na napag i-review on again, no? It will take so much time. But I'd like to concentrate on this, no? Na dumduman nyo nga gintunan naton nga we also have to wear or put on the helmet, which is the hope of salvation. And I explained last time that ining hope na ini, although it is, you know, it has a different meaning in English, but in the original Greek, the word hope is something much stronger because it is certain. Sigurado giniya ang hope na ini, nga Jesus Christ will return to save us. It is not simply a wish nga basi matabo, basi hindi matabo. That's not what the word hope means. In this passage, the word hope means it is a certain hope. It will surely happen. But now the question arises, okay? And we will be easing into our main text. Why is it certain? Nga asigurado nga maluwas gid kita ya. Why is the hope of our salvation secure? Kag diri na masulod ang verse 9 kag 10 pakadto na sa 11. And the answer to that is the hope of our salvation is sure, is certain, is secure because of the power of God, the sovereignty of God. Atuya sa verse 8, during a past Sunday, the focus was on human responsibility. Ang dapat naton himuon. We should exert effort to protect ourselves. We should believe. We should love. We should hope. We should persevere. If you remember, that is part of protecting ourselves, no? On the human level, that's what needs to be done in order for us to be saved. But the focus is on human responsibility. But this time, gina-explicar ni Paul that there is a greater, deeper reason kung secure ka, okay? And your security is ultimately because, basahon ta, God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Dira lang ta anay, no? The main reason, the greatest reason, the number one reason why you are secure, if you are truly God's child, his people, you will really be saved. Hindi mo niya ma-miss. Hindi, you will never perish. You will never be lost. You have eternal life. And the number one reason for that, yes, you do your part, but the main reason for that is because God has destined it. This is going to be solid food, ha? Subong nga aga. But if we are going to grow mature, humble sa Bible, we really have to partake of solid food. I repeat, ang atong pagatun-an subong nga aga is solid food. We are going to explore and study things which are actually beyond our understanding. But God has revealed them to encourage us and to comfort us. And He is telling us, no, I will remind you of some verses. Secure ka. You are secured for the coming. You are not only protected by your efforts to put on the armor, you are secure because it is God Himself who is working. It is not your puny efforts which actually protect you, because behind your puny human efforts, there is the power of God. No one will snatch them out of my hand, says God. Pero diriya sa 1 Thessalonians, ang ambalda, you are secure because God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so verse 8 focuses on human responsibility, but verses 9 and 10 explains why this hope is certain and secure. This time, the focus is on the divine initiative and God's sovereignty. Amuning pagatun anta subong aga. And we are studying it because Paul mentions it. Grabe yung theology ni Paul. Hindi iya contento si Paul nga to just tell you what to do because he knows that will not be enough. He has to mention that behind our efforts, there is a much greater power involved. The power of God. And that is what really secures us. So, sanguna, protected for the second coming by faith, hope, and love, pero subong. Secured for the second coming by God's appointment, and number two, by Christ's atonement. Pero subong aga, part one lang anay. Kaysa diri pa lang, medyo malawigan na tadi. Pero ate, we cannot do anything. If we are really to do justice to the study of God's word, we will have to take time. Okay? So, we are secured by God's appointment. Ining word nga God has not destined us for wrath, it can also be translated as appointed, okay, ordained. But anyway, the idea here is that it is God who is working. Okay. Now, this is very important for salvation. By the way, we are not talking about the human level here. Ang ginaistoryahan ta subong niya, medyo amuna hambal ko solid food ni siya, damo di misteryo nga hindi ko masabat because iya na niya perspectives ang Ginoo. Ha? So, I will mention them because they're in the Bible and we have to know them. Hindi pwede nga hindi tani mabalaan because the Bible says all scripture is profitable and it's a pity if Christians will not know about these things kay ginatudlo man ari nga basa Bible. Why is God's appointment very important? Why do we need to understand it, especially in order to appreciate the grace of God in our salvation? Hambal sa Acts 13:48. When the Gentiles heard this, they began rejoicing and glorifying the word of the Lord. And as many as were appointed to eternal life believed. Why did they believe? Yes, they were saved because they believed. But there was a far greater power involved. They were appointed to eternal life. And because they were appointed, they believed. It's as simple as that, as clear as that, even if it boggles the mind and perplexes the brain. That is the teaching of the scriptures. 2 Thessalonians 2:13. But we ought always to give thanks to God for you, brothers beloved by the Lord, because God chose you as the first fruits. God chose you to be what? To be saved. Through sanctification by the Spirit and belief in the truth. If ever you became receptive to the Holy Spirit, if ever you believed in the truth, repented of your sins, and your heart and mind was open to embrace the gospel, what was the deeper reason behind all of that? God chose you. You did not choose me, but I chose you. That's John 15:16. We love him because he first loved us. This is the divine initiative. Remember those words. The divine initiative. It is always God who acts first. And we will know the reasons in a little while. Number one, first thing you have to know about the God, about the appointment of God, it is eternal. What does that mean? It means that God made that decision not only before you were born, but here it becomes even more staggering. He made that decision before he created anything. Grabe, no? I mean, how can our minds contain this truth? Hambal diri sa Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3 to 4. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. Lang to wabla, you were chosen. When did it happen? Before the world was created, before the foundation of the world, in order to be what? To be holy and blameless. Those are synonymous with salvation because salvation is about becoming holy and blameless. By the way, question, did God choose you because he foresaw that you will be holy and blameless? No.
He chose you in order to be holy and blameless. Your becoming holy and blameless someday is a result of His choosing, not the basis for His... Paminsan, ay nakitaan sa Ginoo na someday I will be born and I will be a very good and holy person and I will receive Jesus Christ. And because of that, nanamiyan ang Ginoo sa akon, bisan wala akong bata, na-force niya. Therefore, He chose me. No, that's not what the Bible is saying. Is this not very clear? He chose you in order so that we should be holiness and blamelessness, salvation, justification, sanctification. All of that is a consequence of the choosing, not the basis of the choosing. That's why I'm doing this, you know, gina-idiit ko ni, so that, because sometimes, kapilanan ni natin mabase, but we do not understand because we do not take time. Even nga lang taon pa lang ang sequence, balas ang logic sa scriptures. The choosing comes first, then the holiness and blamelessness follow. Which, as I said, this is actually a catchphrase for salvation as a whole. Because salvation ultimately is about holiness and blamelessness. But anyway, let's go to 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 9. Let us hear what God's word is teaching us. God saved us, called us to a holy calling. Okay, why? What was the basis? Not because of our works. But here, it becomes, again, staggering. But because of His own purpose and grace. Oh, that's a nice term, grace. But read further. He gave us this grace in Christ Jesus before the ages began. Before time began. That grace was given to us. What does that mean? Frankly, it's very hard to explain because tamaan na gid niya kami. I don't know how to explain it. All I know is that God chose us not because of our works, not because of anything in us, but because of His own purpose and grace, which He gave us in Christ Jesus before the ages began. And that means the grace of God is more amazing than you will ever realize. Ang aton pag-intindis, ang grace is only confined to this world. It's much greater than that. Even before the world was created, the Lord decided to be gracious to us. Grabe, no? But I cannot explain it as much as I want to because it is just so beyond me. All I know is that, the Bible teaches it. Number two, connected me sa first point. Because God's appointment is eternal, it is also unconditional. Dere makitaan mo ang connection sang eternal kag unconditional. Basi ba mangkot ka? Di ano subong kung ang choice ng Ginoo eternal. Here's the explanation. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. Jeremiah 1:5. Pero Romans 9:10-16. And not only so, but also when Rebecca had conceived children by one man, our forefather Isaac, though they were not yet born and had done nothing either good or bad, okay? So there is nothing in them which can form the basis of God's choosing them. In order that God's purpose of election might continue, in other translations, might stand, might be established, not because of works, but because of Him who calls. She was told, the older will serve the younger. As it is written, Jacob I loved, Esau I hated. What shall we say then? Is there injustice in God's part? By no means, for He says to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I have mercy. I will have compassion on whom I have compassion. And here is the explanation why it is eternal and unconditional. So then, it depends not on human will or exertion, but on God who has mercy. Why is the election of God eternal? So that it can become very clear that it is unconditional. Because in eternity past, you were not yet born. You had not done anything to deserve God's mercy. But even before you were born, even before God created the heavens and earth, He already made a decision to be merciful to you. That means that decision was gracious and not conditioned on your performance. It was unmerited grace. It was unconditional. But now we go to the next Okay. Pero Ariay, kasi magambal ka, di kung amo naman lang eh, na ang God gali, gina-destine niya, gina-predestine niya, gina-appoint niya kung sino maluwas, eh ang guwasin eh, hindi na lang kita mag-evangelize, pahimuyong na lang kita, hindi na lang kita magbasa Bible, hulat na lang ta. Amo na? No. That is why I said, kinanglan sa mga amo ni klase nga topic na solid food, kinanglan topic to gidya sa pulong sa Ginoo, otherwise matanang ka. Even though there are things here that we do not understand, the important thing is just stick to the Word of God. What it says, we follow, even if we do not understand completely. Now, hambal sang ginbasa ta, God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Buot ko silingon, whatever predestination is, whatever election is, okay, we cannot fully comprehend it. One thing I'm sure of, it's always connected to Jesus Christ. Hindi mo madula si Jesus Christ dire. Kay bisan hambal to kag ina sang Ephesians 1:3-4. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, even as He chose Him in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before Him. What does this mean? I will repeat. I do not understand completely. I just understand a very little bit about predestination and election. But one thing I'm sure of, konektado ginagay Kristo. So a person who does not receive Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior is not appointed unto salvation. Inaya sigurado ko. So hindi pwede din magpahimuyong. I will explain it more in a little while. Hindi pwede nga, hindi ka na mag-evangelize. Kaya hindi pwede nga maminsar ka ate. Kung eleko, maluwas ko. Wala na giluay, wala na batunay kay Kristus. Wala na pamatiay, wala na evangelize. No, that is not how it works. Because the Bible says, He chose us, yes, He chose us before the foundation of the world. But in Christ, ara niya kung si Kristo. So as I said, ako ya, I just stick to the Bible. If a person will not receive Jesus Christ, hindi siya maluwas. Kung hindi kita mag-evangelize, kung hindi mabatihan sa ibang si Jesus Christ, hindi sila maluwas. It's as simple as that. Because even though there is such a thing as election and appointment and predestination in the Bible, it says in Christ. So muna, even though I believe in election, I also believe in John 3:16, whosoever will. Why? Because election is Christological. It's in Christ. Hindi mo pwede dulaon si Kristo. Hindi diya pwede ang immobility and passivity just because there is such a thing as election. Kaya ang election din, this is not according to human wisdom. This is according to divine wisdom. And the wisdom of God says, yes, I decree, I destine, but it is in Christ. Hindi pwede madula di si Kristo. Okay? Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger. Whoever believes in me shall never thirst. But I said to you, that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me. Whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. So security man ni Gyapon, kagparte man is election. Because, hindi ko lang galing gusto mag-uot de, kay base maglawig eh. Pero, if you have time, you read John 6:35-40. Ang context niya muna yan, this is the context. There were some people who were listening to Jesus Christ, but they would not believe. Paminsarabala, si Jesus na nang gawali, hindi pa sila magpati. Kung silingon si Jesus Christ, waiwaay nga preacher. Di pala, anak siya sang Diyos, nga hindi siya mapatihan. Why is it that they do not believe? Kagin sabat ni Jesus Christ, grabing sabat niya, eleksyon ang sabat niya. Ambal niya, all that the Father gives me will come to me, whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. Anong bot niya silingon, why ka mo kapati? Eh, wala ka mo yagin pili, wala ka mo yagin hatag sa akon, sa ngakon. Eh, ang depekto, wala sa akon. Ang depekto ara sa inyo. Kagambal niya, the reason why anyone comes to me is because God gave them to me. My Father gave them to me. Tapos, ari pagid niyo, I came down from heaven not to do the will of Him, but the will, not to do my own will, but the will of Him who sent me. Ari dalong ni siya na statement. Ha? Buot sa lingon sin eh. I'm sorry if I go fast. Ato pa lang si Jesus Christ with the Father in eternity in heaven, ang will ni sang Father, gin-reveal na. What is the will? That I should lose nothing of all that He has given me. I-connect mo ni sa Ephesians, anong buot sa lingon sin eh. In eternity past, God gave us to Christ. kagintagaan niya si Jesus Christ ng charge. Luwason mo ni sila. Kinanglan, hindi gini sila madula. Ha? You are going to go down to earth from heaven in order to accomplish my will. And my will is that you will lose none of all that he has, that I have given to you. And this is, I will make sure of this. All that I gave you, they will come to you. So, now, dalum, no? Pero ti, padayon ta, at least I'm just showing you the verses. All that the Father gives me will come to me. Whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. This is the will of him who sent me. I was sent from heaven to come down on earth, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me. God has already given us to Christ. Our coming is a result of his giving. All that the Father gives me will come to me. Okay. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. That's why I said kagina, whatever predestination is, whatever God's appointment is, whatever election is, all I know is this. Nga hindi mo pwede madula di si Kristo. If Christ is not preached and people will not receive Jesus Christ, no matter how much that person claims to be elect, he will not be saved. Because election is in Christ. In order to be saved, you really have to be in Christ. You really have to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, we're going fast. God's appointment is doxological. Nang wala ko kabalo, I know I'm raising a lot of questions here, ha? We might do something different in this service. If there are any questions, depende ni sa kay Pearl and kay Joyce. I do not know if we are going to entertain some questions later on and whether we should do that in a worship service. But let's just allow the Holy Spirit to lead us. Okay. God's appointment is doxological. Why does God choose the way he does? And ultimately, even though we cannot fully understand the reasons, ultimately, it is because this is for his glory. Grabe, no? Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. In love, he predestined us for adoption to himself. Again, ha? Bantayin nyo, ha? Ang adoption is a consequence of predestination. If ever we became God's children, it was because he predestined us to be so in the first place. That's what the Bible says. According to the purpose of his will, and here is the reason why he does that. Why does he choose the way he does? To the praise of his glorious grace with which he has blessed us in the beloved. Now, let us allow Scripture to interpret Scripture. Diba si Mamangkot, anong meaning sinang to the praise of His glorious grace? And now, we come to one of the most difficult passages in the Scripture. Solid food, din niya. Romans 9:15 to 24. He says to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I have mercy. I will have compassion on whom I have compassion. So then, it depends not on human will or exertion, but on God who has mercy. For the scripture says to Pharaoh, for this very purpose I have raised you up, that I might show my power in you, and that my name might be proclaimed in all the earth. So then, he has mercy on whomever he wills, and he hardens whomever he wills. You will say to me then, why does he still find fault? For who can resist his will? But who are you, O man, to answer back to God? Will what is molded say to its molder, why have you made me like this? Has the potter no right over the clay to make of the same lump one vessel for honorable use and another for dishonorable use? What if God, desiring to show his wrath and to make known his power, has endured with much patience vessels of wrath prepared for destruction in order to make known the riches of his glory for vessels of mercy, which he has prepared beforehand for glory? Even us whom he has called, not from the Jews only, but also from the Gentiles. So what is the answer? Why does God choose the way he does? And the answer is, so that his grace and his mercy will be glorified in a way much greater than we will ever understand. Because if everything depends on God, even our salvation in all its aspects depends on the sheer and pure and absolute mercy of God. But Lingon, there is nothing in ourselves that we can really boast about. Hindi kagidya makahambal yang nalugo yang Ginoo sa akon, kahit there is a spark, a remaining spark of goodness in me. That is not the answer. He, the glory of His grace, which the Lord wants to make known, is this: I will have mercy on whom I have mercy. Even though the object of my mercy is undeserving, that does not matter, because I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. How do I explain that? Again, I do not know. All I know is that there it is. And this is not the first time. Even in the Old Testament, ari na ni siya, inilawig ni siya ng verse, pero let me read this. Therefore, I say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I am about to act, but for the sake of my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations to which you came. Luwason ko kamo, not because you deserve it, kay ginbastos nyo ganing akong nganan, but in spite of that, I will vindicate the holiness of my great name, which has been profaned among the nations and which you have profaned among them. And the nations will know that I am the Lord, declares the Lord God, when through you I vindicate my holiness before their eyes. Okay, lumpat kita. I will sprinkle clean water on you. You shall be clean from all your uncleannesses. From all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart, a new spirit I will put within you. I will remove the heart of stone from your flesh. I will give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you. Cause you to walk in my statutes and be careful to obey my rules. Does this not remind you of holy and blameless? You shall dwell in the land I gave you. You shall be my people and I will be your God. Why did God do this? Not for your sake, O house of Israel. Not for your sake, Christians. I am about to act for the sake of my holy name. My holy name is sovereign and merciful. I will have mercy on whom I have mercy, and you shall be my people. I will be your God, not for your sake, but for my sake, says the Lord Almighty. For His glory, it is His good pleasure, not because of anything good in us. Okay. Ari pagid. Why does God choose the way He does? Hindi ko lang nikang pagbasaon gid tanan natin taman kalawig. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 1, 22 to 31. Ang nakabo dere, if you remember, ang mga Gentiles, wala nila ginbato ng gospel kay para sa ila kabuangan na. You mean we are saved by means of a person dying on a cross? Amo man sa mga kwan, amo man sa mga Hudeyo, ang kaluwasan galiya, hindi pagi sa political liberation from the yoke of Rome, pagi gali niya sa someone dying on the cross. Ano na yaman? That's foolishness, that's weakness. So the gospel was rejected, huh? by the elite intellectuals. It was rejected by intelligent people. Pero ano ang balsang Bible, ha? Foolishness, ha? We preach Christ crucified, to Jews a stumbling block, and to the Gentiles foolishness. But to those who are the called, the power of God and the wisdom of God. Arina. Connected na this topic ta. Listen to this. Consider your calling, brethren, that there were not many wise according to the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble. God has chosen the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God has chosen the weak things of the world to shame the things which are strong. The base things, the lowly things, ang mga nubugid of the world, and the despised, ang gina-ostracized. God has chosen them. the things that are not, ang mga waay-waay, did amuniya ang gintili sa Diyos, that He may nullify the things that are so that no one may boast before God. But by His doing, you are in Christ Jesus. It is not because of anything in us. It's because of the initiative of God that we are in Christ, who became to us wisdom from God. Why did we understand ang mga maalam na tao? Wala kang hindi. Let me ask you this question. Why do you understand the gospel? Is it because you are holier than others? Is it because you are more intelligent than others? Is it because you are more righteous than others? No! It is because of the grace of God. Because God chose you. By His doing, you are in Christ Jesus, who became to us wisdom from God, righteousness, sanctification, and redemption. So that just as it is written, let him who boasts in the Lord. He chose us the way He chose, the way He did, unconditionally, eternally, so that all the glory might go to Him. Wala gid kita sang ibugal. Hindi naton maipabugal ang aton kaalam. Kay hindi tungod sa aton kaalam nga naintindihan ta ang mayong balita. Ang mga maalamon gani, hindi nila maintindihan. Pero kita, naintindihan kita. Kaklaro sa ngambal. I know, brethren, this might shake some of you. Nag-inantisipar ko na na yan. Some of you are being shaken, but it is my duty to teach you the Word of God. And this is what the Bible says. If ever you understand the wisdom of God in the gospel, if ever you understand salvation, which is foolishness to the intelligent, it's because He chose you. Damo pa na versikulo, I will show you in a little while. But here's the reason, doxological. Let him who boasts in the Lord. Lord, thank you nga naintindihan kong mayong balita. Kung wala mo kong ginhatagan sa pag-intindi, wala gid ko naluwas. Hindi nigali maintindihan bisan sang maalam. Di, so, mas nagid ako, paano ko naintindihan kung wala ka naghatag kaluoy kagrasya sa akon nga ginabrihan mong mata mo, mata ko by means of your own initiative. That is the grace of God. Finally, God's appointment is paradoxical. For God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Ang questions mo nga muni. Kagina, ginmensyonar ko na ni Tibot silingon sini, wala nagid kita sa himuon, makungko na lang kita, maulat na lang kita, hindi kita mag-evangelize, hindi kita magbasa Bible, hindi kita magtuo kay Kristo Jesus, hindi. Just stick to the Bible even if you do not understand. Yes, He has destined us for salvation. Pero He uses the word obtain. Kagang buot silingon sang obtain, you have to exert effort. You have to believe. You have to repent. Tapos, although I mentioned nga perseverance is not a condition for salvation, it's a characteristic of the saved, you have to persevere. You have to be holy. You have to do your part. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord. Basi magambal ka, Dennis, Attorney Cortes, paano mo siya i-reconcile? Karoon na lang ng reconciliation, basta subong, just stick to the Word of God, please. Huh? Now, anong hambal sa Bible? There is a look, hambal, na ang mga disciples nag-question kay Jesus. He went through the cities and villages, teaching and journeying toward Jerusalem. Then said one unto them, Lord, are there few that be saved? Lord, jutay lang ang maluwas. But Jesus did not answer the question. He said, strive to enter in at the straight gate, for many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able. Anong butslingon sa atong Ginoo? Kita, we are very curious people. Gusto naton mamangkot, siya luwas siya, siya elect siya predestined siya. Ang buti silingon ni Jesus, abayin na lang na. Ang imo yung problemahan ang kogalingon mo. Natuo ka bala sa akon? Luwas ka bala? Nag-repent ka na bala? Strive, ha? In a sense, in the meantime, forget about election. Strive to enter in at this. Magsiling ka, strive. Make every effort. Kinanggan himuon mong bahin mo nga magtuo kagid kay Kristo. Otherwise, you will not be saved. Because many are seeking to enter in, but shall not be able. You have to strive. Okay, next. 2 Peter 1:10. Therefore, brothers, strive to make your calling and election. Aria, grabe na yung verse. Di bala ang election sa Ginoo? Sigurado na na yan? Yes. As far as the divine level is concerned, as far as the divine perspective is concerned, of course, it's sure and certain. God's will cannot be thwarted. God's eternal will cannot be defeated. But The Bible at the same time says, strive to make your calling and election sure. On the human level, siguraduhon mo nga nagatuhof again. Colossians 1:22-23, Jesus Christ has now reconciled in his body of flesh by his death in order to present you holy and blameless and above reproach before him, if indeed you continue in the faith. Kita nyo na? On the human level, you have to do your part. You have to believe and you have to continue in the faith. Okay? Otherwise, prangka na lang, you will not be saved. Pero, on the other side, sa divine level, kay basi mamangkot ka, basi makulbaan ka, kay what if I do not continue in the faith? What if I do not persevere? Inayang striving, human level, pero diri naman niya sa divine perspective, the steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be cast headlong, for the Lord upholds his son. Grabe, no? And the Lord will never forsake him. Ang butsilingon sinya mo ni. Ang Bible nga nagahambal, imuon mong bahin mo nga magkapyot kas Ginoo. But ultimately, hindi ka mahulog kay siyang gakapyot sa imo. Grabe, no? Duha ka kamaturan eh. Both of them are working together and they're very deep. On the one hand, from our perspective, we have to do our part to cling to God. We must hold on to Him. Continue in the faith. Strive to enter the narrow gate. But from the divine perspective, this child of mine, he will never fall. He might stumble, but he will not fall because I will never let go of him. But because you are not my sheep, you refuse to believe. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them. They follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and the Father are one. Which leads us to our question, how do you reconcile this? Do you appreciate the tension here? Kita nyo ang dilemma here? Ano gidya bala? May election? May appointment? We are secure by God's appointment? Pero diri naman niya sa piyak na bahin, dapat siya siguraduhon kung gidya elect ako? Dapat? I will do my part? Yes. The secret things belong to the Lord our God, but the things that are revealed belong to us and to our children forever, that we may do all the words of this law. Botsilingon, inang mga misteryo sa Ginoo, iyan aya. Kung hindi mo manggid maintindihan, kung hindi naton maintindihan, leave it to God. Basta ang importante, ang mga butang nga ginpahayag niya sa aton, we will have to obey them. And He commands us, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord. Repent of your sins, and you will be forgiven. He who endures to the end will be saved. Those are the things that have been revealed to us. And according to this, the secret things belong to the Lord. But the things that are revealed, we should do them. Abuna kasimple. But silingon, ultimately, election has been revealed for our comfort. Pero hindi tani wala ta. Hindi tani dapat padaluman gid. Kay hindi ni naton matukit. Basta batunon ta lang. Pero ang mga butang nga ginsugo sa Ginoo, amo na yang tumanon ta. Okay? Hari pagid. I'm sorry nga naglawig, no? Pero pasalamat na lang kita nga wala ko gin-include ang part 2. Kung include kong part 2, wala butang kita doa ka oras. Pero sige, pero hari ayo, nato habla. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. Kaya di ko elect, Paul, hindi ko nibalaki ang chindis ang ginahambal mo. Elect man ni sila. Tingaan, nagapangabudlay, kagit nga itudlo, kagiwali ang mayong balita, kang sabat ni Paul, so that they will obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus. Yes, elect sila. But I have to endure everything for the sake of the elect para masigurado nga malambot gid nila ang kaluwasan nga ginpromisa sa ila. How do you I do not know how to reconcile this. Basta ara elect. But you have to endure everything for the sake of the elect, otherwise they might never mind, I do not know. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But then will they call on him? How will they call on him on whom they have not believed? How are they to believe in him on whom they have never heard? How are they to hear without someone preaching? How are they to preach unless they are saved? Okay, so faith comes from hearing and hearing through the word of God. Anong butslingon? Okay, may election. We already know that. Pero kung wala walihay, wala evangelism, no one will be saved. That's why hindi pwede. That's why yung pagkinsindi ko, muna yung simplihon ko na lang niya. I believe in election, but I also believe in evangelism because I just stick to the word of God even when I do not understand. From God's perspective, I know that He chose before the foundation of the world those who are going to be saved. But from our perspective, the human level, we have to evangelize, we have to believe, we have to repent, otherwise we will not be saved. I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they may obtain salvation. Na. Finally, lapit na lang ka matapos. Isa na ko ka oras. Lambot na ko isa ka oras? Ayan, okay. Lambot na ko isa ka oras. Tama na ko na ang balibong. Finally na nyan, last na nyan. Election is like a door with a sign on the outside which says, whosoever will. And another sign on the inside which says, elect before the foundation of the world. Election is like the rails of a train. They are parallel. They will never meet as far as the human mind is concerned. But the train of salvation needs both the rail of divine sovereignty and the rail of human responsibility to reach its destination. They will never meet. Parallel na yun mo. But they are both needed. Okay? So, actually, 80% pa lang ta. Pero sige na lang. I will have mercy. Okay. Never mind that. I will go to our take home. Okay? God's grace is so much greater than we can ever imagine. No? Nang abi nato ng grasya sang Ginoo nga Jesus Christ died on the cross for us. That's true. That's the grace of God. But much greater than that is He chose us before the foundation of the world. We are secure for the second coming because God has not appointed us to wrath but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Lord, kabalo kami nga solid food. Gid ni Lord ang natunan namon sa pulong nimo pero ga pati kami Lord in what you said that all scripture is profitable. Lord, thank you that our security does not depend on us. It depends on you, your sheer mercy and grace. Even though we do not understand it, O Lord, just help us to appreciate it. Help us, Lord, to boast in the Lord only, to boast in you only. Naluwas kami, nagtuo kami, naginulsul kami, ultimately, not because there is anything good in us, but because for reasons known only to yourself, you have chosen us for your glory. Lord, natumduman pong kanta, why have you chosen me? Yes, O Lord, that is the question. We might never know why, but we will always praise you and glorify you because you have done so. So that we who are saved might not boast in ourselves, but in you alone. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.